The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God of the covenant, as the 40 days of deluge swept away the world's corruption and watered new beginnings of righteousness and life, so in the saving flood of baptism, your people are washed clean and born again. Throughout these 40 days, we beg you, unseal for us the wellspring of your grace. Cleanse our hearts of all that is not holy, and cause your gift of new life to flourish once again. Grant this through Christ, our liberator from sin, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, holy and mighty God, forever and ever. Amen.
Good morning to each and every one of you.
Good morning.
And indeed a warm welcome to our act of worship here today. I extend a warm welcome to those who may be visiting in our midst, as well as to our online congregation worshiping with us via our Facebook page. Now today is the first Sunday in Lent, and as we gather in worship, our liturgy will have some differences from what we are used to. We're going to begin with the Great Litany, which was first written about 500 or so years ago. It is an all-encompassing prayer, which can help us to set the tone for Lent. It is usually chanted, but this morning it will be said. Now, the ideal posture for this type of prayer is to kneel, but we know that everyone is not able to kneel, or able to kneel for a prolonged period of time. So as we pray the Great Litany, I invite you to assume the posture that is better for you, whether it is kneeling or sitting. I invite you now to sit or kneel. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O God, the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide,
have mercy upon us.
O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, three persons in one God. Lord, remember not our offenses, nor the offenses of our forefathers. Spare us, good Lord. Spare your people whom you have redeemed with your precious blood. From all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the cunning assaults of the devil, from your wrath, and from everlasting condemnation. From all spiritual blindness, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, malice, and all uncharitableness. From fornication, adultery, and all other disordered and sinful affections. From the deceits of the world and the snares of the devil. From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism. From hardness of heart, and from contempt of your word and commandment. From lightning, fire, and hurricane. From earthquake, drought, and flood. From famine, plague, and pestilence. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion. From violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your birth, childhood, and obedience, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, by your ministry in word and work, by your mighty acts of power, by your proclamation of the kingdom, by your agony and sweat of blood, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, by your mighty resurrection, by your glorious ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Spirit. In all times of trial and sorrow, in all times of joy and prosperity, in the hour of death and at the day of judgment, hear our prayers, O Lord our God.
Hear us, O Lord.
Govern and direct your holy church. Fill it with love and truth, and grant it that unity which is your will.
Hear us, O Lord.
Give us boldness to preach the gospel in all the world, and to make disciples of all nations.
Hear us, O Lord.
Enlighten all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding, that by their life and teaching they may proclaim your word.
Yes, Lord.
Give your people grace to hear and receive your word, to find and follow their true vocation, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived.
Hear us, Lord.
Strengthen those who stand. Comfort and help the faint-hearted. Raise up the fallen. And finally beat down Satan under our feet.
Hear us, Lord.
Guide the leaders of the nations into the way of justice and peace.
Hear us, Lord.
Enlighten and direct our rulers. Grant that they may put their trust in you and seek only your honor and glory.
Yes, Lord.
Grant wisdom and insight to all in authority, and to judges and magistrates, the grace to administer justice with mercy.
Hear us, O Lord.
Give to all nations peace, unity, and concord, and grant to all people freedom and dignity, food and shelter.
Hear us, O Lord.
Teach us to use the resources of the earth to your glory, that all may share in your goodness and praise you for your loving kindness.
Hear us, O Lord.
Enlighten with your spirit all who teach and all who learn.
Hear us, O Lord.
Help and comfort the lonely and aged, the bereaved, the overworked, the exploited, and the oppressed.
Hear us, O Lord.
Support and encourage all who are in poverty, unemployment, or distress. Protect those whose work is dangerous, and keep in safety all who travel.
Hear us, O Lord.
Keep fathers, mothers, and children united in their family life, and give them wisdom and strength in times of stress.
Hear us, O Lord.
Heal the sick in mind and body. Strengthen and preserve all women in childbirth and all young children.
Hear us, O Lord.
Defend and provide for the widowed and the orphaned, all migrant workers and refugees, the homeless and victims of strife. Have pity on prisoners and all who live in fear.
Hear us, O Lord.
Forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and turn their hearts.
Hear us, O Lord.
Savior of the world, forgive our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may amend our lives according to your holy word.
O Lord, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose blessed Son was led by the Spirit to be tempted by Satan, come quickly to help us who are assaulted by many temptations. And, as you know the weaknesses of each of us, let each one find you mighty to save, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the ministry of the word.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Genesis, chapter 9, beginning at the 8th verse. God said to Noah and his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of the flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is a sign of the covenant that I make between me and you, and every living creature that is with you, for all future generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh, and the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth. God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Word of God written in the first letter of Peter, chapter 3, beginning at the 18th verse. Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey. When God waited patiently in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water, and baptism, this prefigure, now saves you. Not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience. Through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, was gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God with angels, authorities, and power made subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord.
Of all our hearts. Be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. I love the writer of Mark's Gospel. He said so much in so few words. And he sent such deep messages, even though his Gospel was the shortest. I mean, take today's reading, for example. Even though he transitioned so quickly from Jesus' baptism to his temptations and didn't give a description of the temptations, as we can find in Matthew or Luke, what he did was still so powerful and even indicative of life in general. What did almost hear him whispering in the background that after major moments in life or high points in life, there are often periods of testing and even periods of being alone. If we cast our minds back to last week, we can remember again that Mark hinted at this as well. Because after Jesus descended the mount, after the glory of the transfiguration, he came down and was confronted with a crisis. From the mountaintop to the valley is seen as one of the patterns of human life. As we think of our lives, we can surely think of our versions of mountaintop experiences that were followed by some challenge in life. But the question is, how did we face it? How did we face it? Think for a few moments about your experiences in the last few days. Surely there were frustrations, temptations, trials, and even tests. But amidst them all, how did you face them? And could those around you tell that you were a Christian? As we think about the tests that we have faced and that we continue to face in our lives, I want us to allow the Greek word for desert to guide us. Now, the Greek word for desert is eremos, and it is a word that has two distinct meanings. One is a place which, though not necessarily dry, is always uninhabited, while the second meaning has to do with a person who is desolate, deprived of friends and kindred, without community. So, although we have in our minds that the desert is a geographical place, I want us to also see it from a psychological perspective as well. Now, with this in mind, let us picture Jesus all alone. But also let us picture that he was led by the Spirit into the wilderness of his own soul. This must have been part of some divine plan, because the same Spirit by whom he was anointed in his baptism was the same Spirit that drove him into the wilderness. In our minds, we can most likely imagine that it was a time for Jesus' personal testing of his vocation, an examination of himself, a mental preparation for the journey ahead of him. It was a preparation that could only be done by stepping away from life's distractions and journeying on the inside of oneself. So let me ask the question of all of us now. How many of us are brave enough to make that journey inside of ourselves? How many of us are ready to look into our very own soul? To be led into the desert of one's soul can certainly be frightening. We are without external support systems. We are forced to see and to come to grips with who we really are. But as scary as facing one's true self may be, it is something that we must do. We must make that journey inside of ourselves. And this Lenten season gives us the opportunity to do this. We can only grow. We can only improve. And we can only become better if we face our own realities. But as scary as it may seem, we do not face these things alone. Just as we saw that Jesus, full of the Spirit, prevails over Satan in the wilderness, and just as he was able to be in a place of vulnerability, to be weak and hungry, and yet not succumb to temptations, through the power of the Spirit, we can do the same. The reality of life is that we all have our wilderness experiences. We are all tempted and tested. But if we are honest with ourselves, we are probably frightened most by the wilderness of our own souls. Today we are tempted by all sorts of old and new perversions of humanity, all types of immorality. But for us as Christians, our greatest temptation is and may always be the temptation to ignore the promises that were made at our baptism. We ignore the promise to see and seek Christ in everyone and to love our neighbor as ourselves. We disregard our Christian promise and duty to strive for justice and peace among all people. We fail constantly to respect the dignity of every human being. It is our failing to not only be who we are supposed to be, but who we promised we would be. That has influenced the downward spiral in some of our societies across the world. We no longer set good examples. We no longer show the better being. We seem to have conformed to the ways of the world. If Christianity is to be more than lip service, and if we are to start to influence this society positively once again, then we need to take this Lenten season seriously and use it as a time of introspection and a time of renewal. We need to take responsibility for ourselves and our own spiritual development and stop waiting on others, because no one can do it for us. We need to make that journey into ourselves and allow God to direct and to strengthen us.
so that we can develop a faith that allows us to walk through the midst of life's temptations. And instead of yielding to the temptations, we would make a positive influence wherever we may be. There's most certainly evil in this world. And so we need to strengthen ourselves spiritually and keep the promise that was made for us in baptism. The promise to renounce the evil powers of this world, powers which seek to corrupt and destroy us. Are we ready to make that journey? Are we ready to make the journey towards a deeper and a stronger faith? A faith that is lived and not only spoken. No one can answer these questions for us. No one can make the journey for us, because it is a journey that starts within us. I pray that we are brave enough to make the journey inwards this Lenten season and onwards, because our communities and our world are not only watching us, but they are also waiting for us to help lift them. So this Lent, what will we do? Amen.
Amen.
Let us reaffirm our faith. As we say in the words of the Nicene Creed, we believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty,
Maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen or unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God.
We
baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
We are the body of Christ. By the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body and have all been made to drink of the one Spirit.
Let us then pursue the things that make for peace and build up the common life.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
As we share the sign of peace, I invite our men's fellowship to take their position as we minister to them. Please.
Encourage you to join in. These are all courses that we all know that we've been singing, as in said, from our eyes or our knees, and so we invite you to sing with us. I've invited two of the young men. I just want to point out quickly to join us. It's part of our mandate as leaders, is to groom the young men to become leaders in the church as well. And so Kajan and Simon are there to sing along with us. Be blessed.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you.
prayer for the presentation of the offering. Father,
we offer you these gifts which you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money.
Repent, we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work, to become through your Holy Spirit, a region of the holy and divine sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love, through the same Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give one of thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. For you bid your faithful people cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that, fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Eucharistic prayer be. Holy and gracious Father, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, whom you sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God, the Father of all. We therefore bring you these gifts, and we ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who offered himself in obedience to your will, the perfect sacrifice for all humankind. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this whenever you drink it, for the remembrance of me." Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Father, call into mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension, his continual intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be filled with your Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May he make us a perpetual offering to you and enable us in communion with Blessed Mary and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessed be your honor and glory and power, be yours forever and ever. Amen.
our Savior has taught us, so we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We break this bread to share with the body of Christ.
Lord, we are ready in our own body, because we all share in one bread.
The Lamb of God.
He is the witness of the world, have mercy on us. The Lamb of God, he is the witness of the world, have mercy on us. The Lamb of God, he is the witness of the world, have mercy on us.
Gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls will feast and be satisfied, and we will sing glad songs of praise to Him.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us bring all our children, all our young people before Almighty God. Heavenly Father, we ask you to look with compassion upon our children. Pour out your blessings upon them and protect them from all harm. Daily strengthen them against the attacks of evil as they journey through this life. No matter how young they may be, we pray that they feel your love and always seek to love you in all that they do. We ask these things through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us the strength and courage
to love and serve you,
and to love our sins in you, with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
With us online. And we have a first-time visitor this morning who we'd like to welcome. Let us say welcome to Samuel Archibald Bush. It's wonderful to welcome you. It's nice. We also have some seasonal visitors. We welcome back Thalia Foster. It's good to have you with us this morning. And I believe I do see Maureen Stocker sitting down there as well. Welcome back. Good to have you. And of course, you would all want me to say what a wonderful presentation this morning. I say presentation loosely. It was just a rousing and spiritual chorus this morning from our men's fellowship. Thank you so much. All grown in number, and I pray that you will continue to go from strength to strength. Thank you for blessing us this morning. Sister Vivian, you look like you have something to say. Shall I bring you the mic?
No, I'm just making a request that I hope they do this at 7 o'clock as well.
Oh! Request for some encores at a slightly earlier time. Wonderful. All right, so moving into our notices for today. So do note that we still have some pledge cards for 2024. They're still available, and you may collect one or a couple from any of the wardens. Please do prayerfully consider joining our stewardship efforts as a church, and pledging is one of these efforts. Completed pledge cards may be placed in the collection plate or returned to one of the wardens. And of course, as we move through Lent during this season, you will notice that there are no flowers in the sanctuary. And we are inviting those this year who would have liked to make a donation of a floral arrangement in celebration of their birthday or anniversary to consider making a contribution towards the purchasing of flowers for Easter. Please do reach out to Sister Yvette Haynes at 926-3211 or to the church office 949-5583 for further information or to indicate your desire to make such a contribution. And following our service this morning at 11:30 a.m., the Cayman Festival of the Arts will be having an organ recital. All are welcome, And admission is free, so we look forward to seeing you there. Right, and I should have started by saying that if there are persons who are celebrating a birthday today or an anniversary, or whom we have celebrated in the past and were not here with us, do feel free to step forward now and to get your blessing.
Thank you.
Every Wednesday evening in Lent for our worship and drama series entitled The People Against Judas Iscariot, the Punishment Phase. We'll begin at 6 p.m. in the church every Wednesday during Lent, so please do come and see what it is all about. And of course, during this Lenten season, we are being encouraged to get to know the Old Testament. Each day in Lent, we will look at a part of the Old Testament through short animated videos. Though done through animation, these videos are quite informative and biblically sound. We will receive the links to these videos via email. You would have received some already, and we will be receiving more over the course of the Lenten season as we get to know the Old Testament together. All right, unless there's anything further, have a wonderful and a reflective day and week.
Thank you.
Sisters in Christ, let us now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Be blessed, reflective, peaceful, energized, day and week to everyone.
Amen.